Hi, so good to see the whole Chinese congregation again.
能看到中文聚会的弟兄姊妹们特别开心。
I think last 3 weeks was very special.
之前的三个星期很特别。
A lot of different guests coming to minister here.
我们有很多特别来宾来分享了他们生命的故事。
And actually, next week is going to be very exciting as well.
下星期也是一样的精彩。
Next week is our final baptism service for the year.
下星期就是我们这一年来的最后一堂的这个洗礼的这个聚会。
And again, we have another, I think 80 over or 90 people getting baptized next week.
估计有80到90位弟兄姊妹要接受洗礼了。
我们就 praise God, hallelujah.
我们赞美主 ，hallelujah。
Now actually, God was giving me a message that I wanted to preach this weekend.
其实这个周末呢，上帝给了我一段信息要跟大家分享的。
But as the weekend approached, God just kind of changed my focus a little bit.
当这个周末要接近的时候呢，上帝给我看到了另外一个焦点。
I actually had a message that was about the prodigal son.
其实是关于一个浪子回头的一个信息。
But probably I'll share it next weekend.
可能我可以下个周末分享。
Because in the last few days, I was dealing with different situations with some people in church.
因为这几天来呢，我在应付着教会的一些会友的一些问题。
And because of that, I thought I should address, I should teach on something.
因此呢，我觉得我要分享另外一个信息。
And interestingly, a lot of the devotional materials I read this past few days surrounded this one issue as well.
很奇妙的，这几天来我的一些灵修的一些资料都读到关于这个话题的。
Now, I think in life, we all want victory.
我们在生命里面呢，都希望得胜的。
We often in church, we pray for breakthroughs.
很多时候我们祷告在教会呢，会有突破。
And we all believe that God will give us breakthroughs, God will give us victory.
而我们相信上帝会赐给我们突破，上帝会让我们得胜。
You know, we like singing those worship songs that are all about victory.
你知道吗？我们唱的敬拜诗歌都通常都是围绕着得胜的这个主题。
But if we're honest with ourselves for a moment,
如果我们坦白一下的话呢？
Very often in life, we feel like we don't always have that victory.
很多时候我们并不是常常得胜的。
In fact, sometimes it feels like somehow everything you try, you don't face any victory.
你甚至觉得你所做的一切呢都没有得着什么突破。
You don't meet success.
你没有得着成功。
Everything you try at work, in ministry, is just not working out.
你在工作上，你在你的事工上，好像做了什么都不是很好这样子。
And it feels like there's this opposition that you're facing in everything that you do.
就仿佛你所做的一切都遇到了很大的阻挡。
And so because of that, I want to share this message with us this weekend.
因此我这个周末要跟大家分享这信息。
The message I have for us this weekend,
这周末的主题叫做什么呢？
It's called your greatest opposition.
叫做最大的阻挡。
The greatest opposition that you ever face in your life.
你会在生命里面会面临最大的阻挡。
Now what do you think is the greatest opposition in your life?
你们认为你们生命里面最大的阻挡是什么呢？
Maybe some of you say fear.
可能你会说是惧怕。
Some people maybe you might say is sin.
有些人可能会说是生命中的罪。
Or maybe you might think it's your own lack of ability.
又或者你自己缺乏很好的才能。
But let me tell you something right now.
可是我要告诉你。
The greatest opposition you will ever face in life.
你生命中会面临到最大的阻挡呢？
It's not sin.
并不是罪。
It's not fear.
并不是惧怕。
The greatest opposition.
最大的阻挡。
Is God himself.
是上帝。
That God will oppose you.
上帝会阻挡你。
If there's something wrong in your life.
如果你生命有什么不对劲儿
的。Let me share with you what scripture says.
让我来给你分享经文。
First Peter chapter 5 verses 5 to 7.
彼得前书第五章第五节到第七节。你们年幼的也要顺服年长的，就是你们众人也都要以谦卑束腰，彼此顺服，因为神阻挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人，所以你们要自卑，服在神大能的手下，到了时候他必叫你们升高，你们要将一切的忧虑卸给神，因为他顾念你们。
Let's come and pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
Lord, we thank you for your word.
主啊，我们感谢你赐给我们这段话语。
We ask that your spirit will be here to teach each and every one of us.
求主的灵来教导我们每一个人。
We pray that it will not just be head knowledge.
我们祷告，我们学的不仅仅是知识。
But there will be a transformation of our hearts.
而是心中的改变。
So come and speak to us.
所以求主来跟我们说话。
In your most precious name we pray.
我们奉你最尊贵的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
So what we just read in 1 Peter chapter 5,
我们刚刚在彼得前书第五章所读到的,
it specifically tells us that God opposes the proud.
就是教导我们说神阻挡骄傲的人。
So when there is pride in our lives,
当我们生命中有骄傲的时候呢,
God himself comes against us.
神就会亲自来阻挡。
And sometimes we need to be very, this, we need to hold this very carefully in our lives.
我们也必须很谨慎的去学习这东西。
Because sometimes maybe when you're going through a moment,
可能当你在经历一个状况的时候,
and you feel like there's no success,
你觉得诶很难有突破有成功,
nothing seems to be working out,
所做的一切都没有效率,
you try this it doesn't work,
都没有成效做这个都不行,
maybe you're looking for work you can't find it,
可能你要找工作你找不着,
maybe you try and reach out to people also no success,
可能你要给人传福音可是也传不到,
maybe you lead a cell group also is not growing,
可能你带领小组小组停滞不前,
and sometimes it feels like there's this opposition,
你觉得好像有很大的阻挡,
this opposition could very well be God,
这个阻挡很可能就是上帝,
and sometimes God opposes us so that we will wake up and understand what we have in our life.
上帝要阻挡我们是让我们苏醒过来来知道我们生命在面临着什么。
See, pride is such a big issue that God will oppose you if you have it.
骄傲这个态度呢是一个很大件事大到上帝会亲自来阻挡你的。
Let's look at what scripture says in Proverbs 16 verse 5.
我们来看一看箴言第16章第5节告诉我们凡心里骄傲的为耶和华所憎恶虽然联手他必不免受罚。
Now the word used there is a very strong word, you know.
这里用的这个字呢是很强烈的。
Okay, in English, use the word detest. It's really very big hatred.
其实中文也是用这个憎恶这个字，是一个很极端的一个字。
You know, Paul was just telling me,
刚才我在说什么？
你好，刚才保罗跟我讲的就是，圣经里没有讲神讨厌这个骄傲。他没有说讨厌不喜欢他的
他用的字是
用的字就是憎恶 which is a very big hatred
这个字呢是比较稍微比较严重一点的
I mean it's the highest level of dislike already
也是最高级的一种不喜欢的意思
because it's such a big issue to God
因为对神来说这的确是一个很大的问题
but the question to all of us today is
可是给大家要学习到的是什么呢要问的问题是什么呢
is pride a big issue to you
骄傲对你来说是一个很大的问题吗
I'm not saying whether you struggle with pride or not
我并不是说你是否挣扎着有骄傲这件事
I'm asking whether do we see this as a big issue
我想问的是你觉得骄傲是问题吗
Because the truth is most of us in church don't you know
我们大部分的人在教会不觉得骄傲是什么问题
You know if somebody comes up to you
如果有人走到你前面
And say well I need to confess some sin some struggle I have
然后跟你说我要跟你忏悔我要跟你认罪
And someone say oh you know I've been cheating on my wife
有人跟你说我出轨了我有婚外情
Oh, you know, I did something so terrible
又或者我做了一件很不好
I stole money from my office
我在办公室我偷钱了我可以用公款了
We hear that
听到的时候
Inside you
你心里面在想哇哇
假辣了
你这个人糟糕
But then if someone comes up to you
可是如果有人来到你面前
They say, well, brother, pray for me
说弟兄你为我祷告
I got pride in my heart
我心里面有骄傲
We won't really react to that
你其实反应并不会这么大
The reason because we don't actually see pride as that big an issue.
因为我们觉得骄傲其实不是很严重的一件事。
But God sees it as such a big issue.
可是在上帝的眼里呢，骄傲是一件很严重的事。
He sees it as a big issue because pride is going to lead to a multitude of problems in our life.
因为骄傲会带领我们生命里面会出现很多问题。
And so if we come back to Proverbs 16 verse 5.
所以如果我们回到刚才的这个箴言第16章第5节。
It says not only does it say that the Lord detests the proud of heart, but they will not go unpunished. Unpunished.
他不单单说心里骄傲的会上帝会憎恶，他也说这个人也必不免受罚。
It means that there will be punishment because of our pride.
也就是因为你有罪，而你将会接受到惩罚。
Now some people may say, "Wow, pastor, that's very harsh."
有人会说，哇，牧师，你这样说太严重了。
God wants to punish us.
上帝要惩罚我。
Listen to me,
听好。
God doesn't want to punish us.
上帝不想。要惩罚你的
like parents here,
就有如家长们一样
you don't want to have to punish your children.
你其实不希望要惩罚孩子的
No parent here enjoys it.
这里没有家长是享受去惩罚自己的孩子的
But there are times that is called for because it needs to be addressed.
可是很多时候我们需要这样做因为我们要应付孩子的一个问题
In fact, the Bible tells us that the Lord disciplines those whom he loves.
经文还教导我们上帝所爱的他必教训
It actually actually goes one line further, you know.
其实还有下一句的。
That it says God chastens or God scolds those that He have accepted as His children.
甚至说上帝会责备或者责骂他认为是他儿女的。
So think about it.
所以试想一下。
If God couldn't care less to punish us.
如果上帝完全不屑你所做的一切。
If He couldn't care less to discipline us.
如果他不觉得需要去管教我们的话。
It means that He doesn't care for us.
也就是说其实他不是很管我们。
But the reason He doesn't is because He does actually care for us.
可是他愿意要去惩罚我们是因为他关心他关爱我们。
I think Charles Spurgeon puts it in the best way.
斯布珍讲了一段话，我觉得特别有道理。无论你对神是多么的宝贵，如果你有骄傲的灵，神必从你心里抽出来。自高自大者，必因神的管教谦卑下来。
God must deal with this pride.
上帝必须要去应付你这个骄傲。
And it's so interesting in the Bible, you know.
圣经里面也教导了我们一些很好的功课。
It doesn't say that God opposes the liars.
他并没有说神阻挡撒谎的人。
Or the adulterers.
或者是出轨的人。
Or the blasphemers.
或者是诋毁神的一些话语的人。
It says He opposes the proud.
经文教导我们，神是阻挡骄傲的人。
And today you and I must understand that proud is so serious.
今天你跟我要学习到这个骄傲呢的灵呢是特别的，是很。
And I'll tell you why.
而我要告诉你为什么。
Because pride is our greatest enemy because it makes God our enemy.
因为骄傲是我们最大的敌人，因为它使神成为我们的敌人。
See, God treats pride with such pride is so serious to God.
这个骄傲对上帝来说是很严重的一件事。
Because pride is something that challenges God's supremacy.
因为它会挑战到上帝的至高无上的这个地位。
See, pride is something that says.I'm good enough.
骄傲就是说什么呢？就是说我已经很厉害了。
It's all about me.
就是我厉害，是唯我独尊。
I have no need for anything else.
我并不需要其他的帮助。
And because of that pride,
而因着有这个骄傲
we see how an angel ultimately became the devil.
我们看见了天使最后成为了魔鬼。
Let's look at Isaiah 14, which tells us what happens to Lucifer.
我们看一看以赛亚书第十四章告诉我们最终撒旦发生了什么事。你心里曾说我要升到天上我要高举我的宝座在神众心以上我要坐在聚会的山上在北方的极处我要升到高云之上我要与至上者同等
I mean listen to those words there
你试看看这些话语啊
What he's saying is that I want to be like God
他说的是我要跟上帝一样一样的地位。
In fact, some parts he says, "I want to be even higher than that."
他甚至说我要在这个地位更上面。
He says, "My throne will be above the stars of God."
他说我的宝座将会在众星神众星之上。
See, that is how toxic pride is.
其实这个骄傲的这个灵呢是有毒的。
And today, all of us need to pay attention to this message.
所以今天我们要关注了。
Now I'm sure maybe some of you sitting here thinking this.
可能在座的各位可能在想。
哇 ，Pastor Daniel, this weekend, wow, such a tough message.
哇，宝亮牧师啊，这周末这个骄傲的这个信息好难搞啊。
哇 ，you know, it's only 10 minutes, you say so much terrible things already.
你才讲了十分钟，我就已经想出去吃饭了。
饿了。Some of us maybe you switched off already.
你可能已经关机了，不想听了。
But today I want to give us a challenge.
可是今天我要挑战大家。
That when you listen to this message,
当你听到这一段信息的时候
，Can you make this one assumption?
你可以先前有一个想法。
What's this assumption?
这个想法是什么呢？
Take it that you are the most prideful person around.
你就当自己是全世界上最骄傲的人。
And this whole message is specifically for you.
而这个信息呢，是对着你而分享的。
I challenge us to do this.
我挑战大家，你现在先有这个假设。
And right now, if you say,
现在如果你说
I cannot and I will not do that.
我做不到，而我不会做。
Then all the more you need to listen to this message.
那你就更需要听这段话语了。
That is a manifestation of pride.
因为这个就是这个骄傲的显现了。
See, we all need to check our hearts so that we can learn and we can grow.
我们大家都需要学习监察我们的心，好让我们可以学习到成长。
And today we must deal with this issue.
而今天我们必须面对着这个问题。
See, what is pride really?
骄傲是什么呢？
Pride is when we are preoccupied with ourselves.
当骄傲呢，就是当你以我为独尊。
You're preoccupied with with what people say about you.
你一直在想着人家所说你的事。
You're preoccupied with how many all the success in your life.
你一直想着你生命中所成功的事。
That is what pride looks like.
骄傲就是这个样子。
And very often we struggle with that.
而很多时候我们有很大的挣扎。
I struggle with pride all the time.
我经常都会有对骄傲有很大的挣扎。
When I was preaching this message last night,
昨天晚上当我在讲这篇道用英文的时候呢，
there's actually a quote that I shared.
其实我分享了一段话。
But I attributed to the wrong person.
其实是一个牧师的名言，可是呢，我写错了那个牧师的名字。
But I always thought this statement was made by this other pastor.
可是我一直以为这一段话是由另外一位牧师写的。
So a member from church messaged me on Facebook.
然后教会有个会友呢，他就在脸书上跟我发了一段话。
I remember the first moment I saw it.
他读了这段话的时候，第一个时间呢
，My reaction was like, "What you say? I wrong, is it?"
我第一个时间就是想，你是不是说我讲错了
？You say I never prepared properly, is it?
你是说我没有准备？好是吧？
So I went to check.
所以我去查了。
I was wrong.
我的确是错的，真的是另外一牧师所写的这段话。
I mean, it was a bit of pride reacting in that moment.
当时我的确是有骄傲，我在有反应。
But when there's pride in our lives,
可是当我们生命中有骄傲的时候
，we're not open to learning.
我们对学习，我们不谦卑，我们没有敞开心。
And so I thank this leader for this this information.
所以我感谢这位组长，他跟我说了这段信息。
Because through this, I've grown. I learned something new.
因为透过这件小事，我学习到了新的事。
And we can only grow.When we are not preoccupied with ourselves,
而当我不会自我为中心的时候呢，我才能真正学习到。
So today I want to tell us how can we effectively deal with the pride in our lives.
所以今天呢，我要跟大家分享我们能够如何去应付我们生命中的骄傲。
Two truths,
两大真理。
Truth number one,
第一大真理。
The first thing we must do is that you must think of yourself less.
我们第一件事要做的呢，就是的确我们要学习少看自己。
That's the first thing we must do.
这是我们学习的第一个功课。
Now this is where I got this point from is from a very common quote in the area of pride.
在骄傲这范围上，通常都会有人有一句名言，而我就取了这个名言来说。
And this is the statement.
就是这句话。谦卑不是小看自己，而是少看自己。
This actually was the quote that I attributed wrongly.
这个呢，就是我写错了，其实是另外一个牧师写的，我以为是另外一个牧师。
A lot of people think it's commonly be attributed to C.S. Lewis.
有一位作家，他叫路易斯，很多人都以为呢是路易斯写的这段话。
But it actually didn't come from him. It came from a pastor by the name of Pastor Rick Warren.
其实啊，是由一位叫做华里克的牧师写的。
And from what I was understanding, he was explaining some things he had learned from C.S. Lewis.
其实他是在当时呢，这个华里克牧师呢，他是在描述他从路易斯作家那边学习到的功课。
And as he was talking about, he made this statement.
当他在提论这件事，他就讲了这段话。
And so somehow he got confused, and people thought it's from.
所以很多人就混淆了，就把这段话说为是路易斯写的。
But whatever it is, I think it's a great point here.
可是我想说呢，这是一个很重要的一点。
That we must think of ourselves less.
我们必须少看自己。
But it's so interesting here. I like this phrasing.
我非常喜欢他写的这个方法。
Because it's about thinking of ourselves less, not thinking less of ourselves.
因为我们的确是要不是要小看自己，而是要少看自己。
Today I'm not asking you to look down on yourself and think you're terrible, you're the worst, you know.
今天我不是要叫你去看扁你自己，而觉得你自己是不好不足的。
But I'm telling us today to not focus always on our own selves.
可是今天我的教导就是不要把所有的专注都摆。在自己的身上。
Don't just focus on our own emotions, our own feelings.
不要老是想着自己的情绪、自己的感情、自己的感觉。
Let's take a look again at 1 Peter chapter 5.
我们再看一下彼得前书第五章第六节、第五节到第七节。你们年幼的也要顺服年长的，就是你们众人都要以谦卑束腰，彼此顺服，因为神阻挡骄傲的人，赐恩给谦卑的人，所以你们要自卑，伏在神大能的手下。到了时候，他必叫你们升高。你们要将一切的忧虑卸给神，因为他顾念你们。
Now it's very interesting. I highlighted a few keywords.
我也特别的注点了这段话里面的一些词。
Because this passage repeatedly tells us to turn the focus away from ourselves.
因为这段经文呢，不断的提醒我们要将那个专注呢，不要摆在自己的身上。
The first thing it tells us to do is to submit to our elders.
他所说的第一个字呢，就是在第五节，他说你要顺服年长的。
And this elders here doesn't just refer to older people, but it refers to earthly authorities.
他说的这个年 年长的呢，不单单只是说年老的人，而是权威权柄的人。
Secondly, it says we have to be humble towards one another.
而且第二句呢，他就是说你要对彼此谦卑。
The third thing it says that we are under the hand of God.
第三呢，他说第六节就是我们要在神大能的手什么手下。
And finally, it says that we are to cast our concerns upon God.
而最后第七节，他说我们要将我们的忧虑卸给神。
See, everything it says here is pushing us upwards.
这里所说的一切呢，都是要把我们推向往外的。
It's telling us to focus on the community, to focus on God that is around us.
教导我们，我们要专注而服侍到我们的周围群体，还有将我们的专注呢仰望神。
Now,Today, when we talk about thinking less of thinking of ourselves less,
今天呢，当我们说到我们要学习少看自己的时候呢
，it means that we must no longer be fixated on our successes.
也就是说，我们不要再专注于我们自己的成功之事。
But at the same time, to not be fixated on our failures as well.
也同样的，不要太专注于你的失败。
Now, I know when I talk about pride.
当我说到骄傲的时候
，Some of us here may think, "Oh, this doesn't apply to me."
我们可能会觉得，哎，这不关我的事。
The reason for that is because we have the wrong understanding of what pride is.
因为我们对骄傲这件事有一个错误的观点。
Very often we think that pride equals arrogance.
很多时候我们就认为骄傲代表着傲慢。
It's actually two different things.
其实它是两回事。
Arrogance is a byproduct of pride.
傲慢呢是一个态度，它是从骄傲而来的。
Now, when we talk about this whole issue of pride,
当我们说到骄傲这件事的时候
imagine that there's a scale.
你试想想，我们有一到十的一个指数。
Okay, on one extreme,
可能从一边。
Okay, pride manifests itself in the form of arrogance.
啊，这个骄傲呢，会以傲慢的态度显现出来。
Arrogance is someone who looks down on people.
当一个很傲慢的人，他会怎么样呢？他会看不起别人。
They are full of themselves.
他们都是自我以为中心的。
They think they are the best.
他们觉得自己是最好的。
They know better
than everybody else. 他们觉得自己懂得比别人多。
And we all understand this.
而我们理解的。
But we always misunderstand and think that this is what pride is.
我们会以为傲慢就代表这就是骄傲的意思。
That's why we think the solution to this, right, is humility, is you think less of yourself.
所以我们一直觉得这个解决的方案呢，就是小看自己，就是要谦卑。
Singaporeans do that a lot, right?
新加坡人很喜欢这样做的。
When people go up to you,
有人去到你面前，
哇、wow, ，you're very good, you know?
哇，你讲的真好。
哇、wow, ，you did this very well, you're the best, you know?
你做这件事，你是新加坡最好、最厉害的。
What do you say?
你说什么？
啊、no lah, no lah.
没有啦，没有啦。
Very lousy one.
没有啦，我很差的啦。
I don't know one,
I
don't know one.
然后就退后两步。
That's not humility, you know.
这并不是谦卑。
That's not humility at all.
这并不是谦卑。
It's like you go to school that time,
你去到学校。
It's always that one student.
总会有一个学生。
You get the test results back.
拿到成绩的时候。
Then you go to person. How much you get?
你去到同学那边，哎，你考几分？你考几分
？Very bad, very bad.
哎呀，不好了，不好了，不好了。
95
upon 95分。
Smack you 啊！
打你一巴掌。
That's not pride, you know.
这并不是谦卑。
That's a different manifestation of pride.
这是另外一种显现。
So on pride one side, you got arrogance.
所以在一边呢，从一端呢，我们就觉得这个是傲慢。
But there's another extreme side.
可是有另外一端。
This extreme side.
这另外一端是什么呢
？It's called shame.
是叫做羞愧。
Let me explain 啊。
我解释一下啊。
Early on, I told us what pride is.
刚才我分享了什么是骄傲。
Pride is when we're fixated on ourselves.
啊，骄傲呢，就是当你看自己，把自己看得特别重。
How people look at us.
人家如何看待我
？What people think of us.
人家如何去想我们，我们的成败。
So on one hand, arrogance.
所以在一边厢呢，就是傲慢。
These are people who are fixated on their successes.
这些人呢，就特别看重自己的成就。
I've accomplished this.
哇，我成就了许多。
I studied here, you know.
哇，我在这个大学。
I'm very smart one.
我很厉害的，很聪明的。
Focus on all those successes.
然后就专注于自己的成功里面。
On all these people here.
另一边厢呢？
Shameful people
就觉得很羞愧的人。
They are very fixated on all their struggles.
他们一直在专注着他们的挣扎。
Oh, cannot one lah.
哇，不可以的啦！
I
我很差的，我永远都不够好的啦。我是一个不好的人。
That is also pride.
这也是一种骄傲。
Because the focus is on yourself.
因为同样的，你专注在于自己很多。
I want to teach us something, 啊。
所以我要教导大家。
I didn't just pluck this out of the air.
我并不是凭空而说的。
I learned this from scripture itself.
我是在经文里面学习到的。
Because scripture actually teaches us this in the book of Proverbs.
因为经文呢是在箴言有教导到我们的。
Proverbs chapter 11 verse 2.
就是在第十一章第二节教导我们，傲慢带来羞辱，谦卑者有智慧。
It brings about disgrace at the end of the day.
最终是会带来羞辱的。
There is shame and there's arrogance.
有羞愧也有傲慢。
They are both things that are a byproduct of pride that is in our lives.
他们俩都是因着我们生命中有自己的骄傲，所以才会显现的。
You see ah.Let me explain to you one way we see this. One way I've seen this happen in church.
Okay, 我们看一个观点啊，在我们教会里面。
You have the very arrogant people.
你有很傲慢的人。
And they say this.
然后说
，I don't need help.
我不需要帮助。
I don't need my leader to help me.
我不需要我的组长指点我。
I don't need you to contribute to my life.
我不需要你们讲很多话在建造我生命的，不用的。
There you got people who are struggling in shame as well.
另外一方面，挣扎在羞愧之中的。
They also don't want help.
他们也不要得着帮助。
You know why?
你知道为什么吗
？Because they don't want people to know.All the struggles they have.
因为他们不想要有人知道他们生命中有什么挣扎。
I met many people in our church.
我遇见很多人在教会。
When it comes to ministry time,
当我们去侍奉服侍他们的时候
，they don't like to walk down the altar to come and respond.
他们不喜欢来到前面这边来回应。
When I ask them why,
当我问他们为什么不要来前面
，then people will say things about me.
他们担心有人会讲前言闲语。
People will now know, oh, I struggle with sin or whatever.
他们人家会以为，哎呀，现在我对罪在罪里面有挣扎。
But again, that is a focus on yourself.
可是同样的，这个就是太自以。
And we see these both kinds of people here in church.
我们在教会都看见了两类人。
There's some of us here, we're so afraid, we're struggling, but we're so afraid to say it.
我们有很大的挣扎，可是我们不敢说出来。
Because you're worried that people are going to talk bad about you.
因为你很担心有人会说你的坏话，会审判你。
That is a manifestation of pride.
这就是骄傲的其中一种显现。
Which is why today I tell us the first thing we must do is we must think of ourselves less.
所以我跟大家分享，今天我们必须做的第一件事就是要少看自己。
Don't look down on yourself.
不要看不起自己。
Don't think the worst of yourself.
千万不要觉得自己是最坏的。
But instead, just don't think of yourself so frequently.
我们只是求你，要求你不要太多专注问题在自己身上。
Every time something comes up, don't jump to your emotions first.
每次有状况发生，千万不要先凭着自己的情绪而回应。
Don't jump to your own thoughts.
千万不要去用着自己的思维而去回应。
But instead, we should turn to God.
与其我们应该转向上帝。
And that leads me to the second point I want to share today.
而这也带领我们进入到我们第二个要点。
The first thing we must do to deal with pride in our life.
我们第一件事来应付、来面对这、来解决我们生命中的骄傲。
Think of ourselves less.
就是要少看。
But the second thing we must do.
可是我们第二件事该做的事呢
？Is that we must think more of God.
而就是应该多仰望神。
What does it mean to think more of God?
我们说多仰望神是什么意思呢
？It means to place Him on the highest place in our life.
也就是把上帝摆在生命中最重要的位置。
To see Him as the greatest thing in our life.
要把他看为尊，也就是我们生命中最伟大的事。
Because sometimes the struggle with pride is that we don't put God at the highest place.
因为很多时候我们骄傲的挣扎里面，我们就是没有把神摆在第一位。
Pride attempts to bring God further down.
我们的骄傲会使上帝从第一位越放越低。
Let's come back to what we read just now.
让我们回到刚才我们所读的。
First Peter chapter 5 verses 6 and 7.
我们看这个彼得前书第五章第六节跟第七节。所以你们要自卑，伏在神大能的手下，到了时候他必叫你们升高。你们要将一切的忧虑卸给神，因为他顾念你们。
It points out to us here that we must come under the covering of God's mighty hand.
这段经文告诉我们呢，我们必须在神大能的手下遮荫。
So we learn that God is mighty.
所以我们学习到神是有大能的。
But not only that, He's a loving God.
不单如此，他是充满着爱的神。
He cares for each and every
one of us. 他很顾念我们。
And I think this is something I want us to reflect on for a moment.
所以我们呢，必须要做一些反省。
Because I believe that when pride comes into our life,
当骄傲渗入我们生命的时候
it often challenges these two areas that I mentioned in this verse.
会在这段经文里面挑战了我们生命中的两件事
Pride will challenge the greatness of God in your life.
会挑战到神在我们生命中有多伟大
Pride will challenge the love of God that is in your life.
也会挑战到在我们生命里面神对我们的爱
And we see this happening all the time.
所以我们经常都会看到
When we go through a storm.
当我们经历风暴的时候
We go through a terrible situation.
当我们经历了很劣势的一个情况的时候
some of that we've been there before, we're overwhelmed with fear.
我们就会被惧怕给充满了。
Remember the disciples?
记得门徒们吗
They went on the boat with Jesus.
他们跟耶稣到船上。
The storm came.
大风暴来了。
And they thought the storm would destroy them.
他们以为这大风暴会搞到他们翻船全部都会溺死。他们被惧怕给充满了。
What was happening right there?
当时在发生什么事
Was that they actually didn't think that God was the greatest.
他们并没有觉得当下，他们并没有觉得上帝是在于第一位的，最伟大的。
In that moment, the storm was the greatest thing in their life.
在那一刻，那个风暴是有大能大力的，而不是上帝。
So you see what happens there?
所以你看到了吗？
This is God's status, huh?
这是上帝的位置。
And they go through a terrible situation.
然后他们经历了一个逆境。
And they bring God's status down.
然后他们就把上帝第一个位置给慢慢滑下落榜了。
And they put this storm above God.
然后就把这个风暴摆在最重要、最有大能的地位。
And let's think about it. Often we do that as well.
很多时候我们都会这样做。
We're so scared.
我们那么的害怕。
And we don't trust God.
我们不敢去信靠神。
The other flip side I've heard people say is this.
另一边厢，我们也听到朋友说。
They say that, oh, they go through a storm.
他们说他们经历风暴了。
They go through a time of suffering.
他们经历了受苦难的时候了。
And people think, if I go through all this, I don't think God loves me lah.
如果我经历了这么多苦难，我觉得上帝不爱我了。
But again.
可是再一次
we must come to that place of trust.
我们必须回到信靠神的那个地位。
Recognize God is the highest.
你要认同到上帝是至高神。
Trust in Him that He's looking out for you.
你要信靠他，你要知道他在顾念着你。
A few years ago, I was ministering to someone in our church.
几年前，我在教会正在服侍着一名弟兄姊妹。
And this person was at a crossroads.
这个人到了人生的一个十字路口。
This person was considering a new job.
他在考虑着转换工作。
He had been in this job for a long time already.
他在现在现任这份工作已经很多年了。
And now there was a new opening.
然后现在呢，有新的一个就业机会。
And so we're talking about it.
所以我们就在跟他讨论了。
And he said he was praying about it.
然后他就分享他在祷告。
Because he believes God placed him in his current workplace for a reason.
因为他相信上帝呢，把他摆在现在这个位置，这工作的地点是有他的旨意的。
How he even got this job is a miraculous move of God.
他甚至怎么得到这一份工作之前，也是一个神迹。
And he told me that God has spoken to him before and said that he should stay there until God tells him to move.
然后他所领受到，他跟我分享，他领受到上帝跟他说，你要继续留在这个公司，直到我呼召你走为止。
So we prayed about it.
所以我们一同祷告。
And we said, has God spoken?
然后我就问他了，上帝呼召你走了吗？
He said, no.
他说没有。
Okay, so stay lah.
所以就待住了。
So waited a while more.
所以我们就再继续等候。
Still pray.
还在继续祷告。
So I said, has God spoken?
上帝跟你说话了没有？
No.
没有叫你走
continue stay
那你就待在那儿吧
And then finally one day I got word from him
最后有一天呢他就发了简讯给我了
He said, hey pastor
他说牧师啊
Just let you know I took the new job
要跟你分享一下我接了新的工作了
I said, oh wow, is it God spoke to you, is it?
我就问他是不是上帝跟你说话了
He said, no, God didn't speak
他说上帝没有跟我说话
But the window was closing already
可是呢那个机会呢就快没有了
And I actually believe that this is the open door that comes from God
而我相信这是上帝赐给我的一个新机会
And if I take this new job, I can actually do more for God.
如果我接了这个新的工作，我可以为神做更多。
I say, my friend,
我跟他说朋友啊，
you just fell into sin.
你刚刚犯罪了。
You knew you're supposed to wait for God.
你知道你必须耐心等候神的。
But what was the problem with my friend here?
可是我朋友的一个问题是什么呢？
He took things into his own hands.
他就自作主张了。
We often do that.
很多时候我们都这样做。
Because sometimes we don't trust God.
因为我们不够信靠神。
Sometimes we don't trust that He's able to bring us through.
我们不相信上帝会带领我们。
That's why we try and solve problems by our own way.
所以我们靠自己的方法去解决问题。
Or sometimes we think that God's not looking out for us.
我们甚至觉得上帝没有眷顾我吗？
That we know what's best for us.
我知道什么是最好的。
We have to depend on ourselves to look out for ourselves.
我得靠自己来照顾自己啊。
But all that are lies.
可是这些都是谎言。
And some of us, we have struggled with that before.
我们甚至是有挣扎的。
Maybe even right now you're in that situation.
你现在甚至有那个挣扎。
Today you need to say, Lord, I surrender my pride.
今天你要回到主的面前说，主啊，我降服，我卸下我的骄傲。
I want to trust in you and you alone.
我要完完全全的、单单的信靠你。
In Isaiah 55, we are reminded of this.
在以赛亚书第五十五章，上帝提醒了我们。耶和华说：“我的意念非同你们的意念，我的道路非同你们的道路。天怎样高过地，照样我的道路高过你们的道路。我的意念呢，是高过你们的意念。”
So this is a reminder that in every situation, God's ways are higher.
所以这是在提醒我们，我们面临的什么问题、什么情况，上帝的意念跟他的道路都是高过我们的。
And pride must be dealt with because pride tries to bring that down.
而我们必须把这个骄傲给除掉，因为骄傲会把上帝的位置贬低了。
Worse still, it tries to bring us above that.
更糟糕的是把我们自己放在上帝之上。
Let's come back to a very familiar passage.
我们回到一段很熟悉的经文。
The first time that mankind fell into sin.
我们看见第一次人类犯罪的时候。
It's found in the book of Genesis.
也就是在创世纪第三章。 他告诉我们，耶和华神所造的唯有蛇比田野一切的活物更狡猾。蛇呢对女人说，神岂是真说不许你们吃园中所有树上的果子吗？女人对蛇说，园中树上的果子我们可以吃，唯有园当中那棵树上的果子，神曾说你们不可吃也不可摸，免得你们死。第四节，神对女人说，你们不一定死，因为神知道你们吃的日子眼睛就明亮了，你们便如神能知道善恶。
It's a very interesting passage.
这段经文非常的有意思。
Learn, right、
我们可以从中学习到很多。
And you know what is so powerful here?
你知道它里面最有意思的是什么吗？
The devil is so crafty.
魔鬼是非常狡猾的。
He tries to instill pride into us.
他让我们里面的骄傲生长。
And how does he do that?
他怎么做呢？
He begins to cause them to doubt.
他就开始使人开始有怀疑。
What was the you know sometimes when we read scripture?
有时候我们读经文的时候啊
most of us we don't read out loud.
我们不会把它大声的给读出来。
You're reading it in your mind.
我们在心中默念。
And when you read something in your mind,
当你在脑子里在默念的时候呢？
It's quite flat one.
是很平的。
Okay, so if you read scripture in your mind,
所以如果你在脑子里在读圣经，你是默读的话
，You probably say, "Oh, now the snake was more crafty than any of the wild animals the Lord has made." He said to the woman, "Did God really say that?"
你心里面可能是说耶和华神所造唯有神比田野一切的诸活物更狡猾。
That's how most of us read scripture.
可能是没有情绪的，我们会这样子读。
But when we do that, we miss out a lot of dynamics that are happening.
可是当我们这样做的时候，我们就失去了里面的一些精华所在。
There's a conversation happening here.
当时有一段对话。
So the snake goes up to Eve.
所以蛇呢就到夏娃那边说。
And the snake says this, you know.
那蛇就说。
Hey, did God really say you cannot eat?
他说啊，神真的有说不可以吃啊这个树上的果子吗
？He got say that, man.
他真的有这样讲吗？
不呀不。
真的吗？蛇嘛，蛇会伸舌头。
And then what did Eve say?
然后那个女人怎么样回应呢
？He said, "Oh, we can eat everything, but cannot eat of the tree in the middle of the garden. I cannot even touch it, or you will die."
他说，园中树上的果子都可以吃，只有那一棵树的果子不能吃，不能摸，会死的。
What did the snake say after that?
那个蛇说什么
？Won't die one 啦，
不会死的啦。
It's okay one,
没事的。
In fact, I tell you why.
我跟你说为什么
？You know why God said cannot?
你知道为什么上帝说不可以吗
？Because God is insecure.
因为上帝缺乏安全感。
He knows 啊，
他知道。
You eat it only.
你吃了之后啊
，You become just like.
你就有如神那么厉害。
That's what the snake said.
蛇就是这样说的。
What was happening right there?
当时在发生什么事
？Every single thing that the devil was saying.
魔鬼所说的每一句话。
It was an attempt at bringing God down.
就是想把上帝崇高的位置给拉下来。
And then finally, that last statement he said.
然后最后他说的一句话。
You will be God-like.
他就说你们变如神这样子了。
It's now to say to push Eve they all up.
就把夏娃跟神。范围同等的啦。
That was a manifestation of pride right there.
这个就是让我们看见了骄傲的显现了。
And remember just now when I talked about pride.
而刚才我们说到骄傲的时候。
I said there's arrogance.
我说这里有傲慢。
And then there's shame, right?
另一边厢有羞愧。
Do you know what happened to Adam and Eve immediately after?
你知道亚当跟夏娃立即就发生什么事了吗？
God was trying to find them.
上帝要去，他们吃了果子了，然后上帝要去找他们。
God did not see them in the garden.
找不着他们在院子里。
So he called out to them.
所以他就叫了一声他们的名字。
And Adam and Eve said, "We are hiding."
然后亚当跟夏娃就说，我们在躲避。
And God said, "Why are you hiding?"
为什么你要躲避啊？上帝问。
And they said, "Because we realized we're naked and we felt ashamed."
然后他们就回答，因为我们是赤身露体的，我们觉得很羞愧。
And God said this to them.
上帝就跟他们说
，Who told you that you're naked?
是谁告诉你们你们是赤身露体的
？You just pause here for a moment.
停顿一下子。
It's interesting how all these ties in together.
这些呢就是成为一个故事的一个环节了。
Before pride entered,
在骄傲还没有进入生命之前
，they were confident.
他们是很有自信的。
There was no shame.
没有羞愧的。
But the moment that came into their life,
可是那个骄傲进入他们生命的那一刻
，they felt so shameful.
他们就充满着羞愧。他们必须躲避。
See, God did not create us with that sense of shame.
上帝创造我们不是要我们心里面有羞愧的。
The sense of shame is actually learned, you know.
这种羞愧的感觉是学习回来的。
I know today is a, I mean, we live in a different culture right now.
今天我们生活在一个不一样的文化里。
But you see something about children.
可是你也看见小朋友们也学习到一些东西。
I'm talking about young children.
我说的是真的是小朋友哈，很年轻的。
Your young babies and toddlers.
你的婴儿，你的小朋友，小孩子。
They'll run all around your house naked, right?
他们不穿衣服在家里随便乱跑的，有没有？
Because they don't understand the concept of shame, you know.
因为他们不理解什么叫做羞愧。
Because we're not actually born with shame.
因为我们出生的时候，我们里面并没有羞愧的。
Shame and arrogance are things we learn from this world because of pride.
傲慢和羞愧是在当我们长大的过程中是学习到的，因为有骄傲。
Because of a focus on ourselves.
因为我们专注于自己，我们多看了自己。
A young child learns what shame is.
一个年轻的小朋友，他会学习到什么叫羞愧。
When he got 70 out of 100.
当他考试100分只。拿了70分
Then the friends who got 80.
然后朋友拿了80.
Yeah, you're so stupid, you're so stupid.
哎呀，我80你70你笨笨的。
And they learn that sense of shame.
然后他们就知道什么叫做羞愧、排斥、不好意思。
This is something that we carry with us.
这是我们随身而带的。
And God did not intend us to live like that.
上帝的旨意并不是要我们这样子活出来的。
Today, I want to tell us this.
今天我要告诉大家。
You know what's the reason that many of us don't think more of God?
你知道为什么我们并没有多看上帝吗？
Because we have not learned how to trust him.
因为我们并没有学习更多的去信靠他。
There's this very famous passage we all know, Proverbs 3:5-6.
我们有一段大家都耳熟能详的一段经文，就是在箴言第三章第五节到第六节。你要专心仰赖耶和华，不可依靠自己的聪明，在你一切所行的事上都要认定他，他必指引你的路。
Most Christians know this verse.
很多基督徒都懂得 这段经文吧。
Someone has blessed you with it sometime before.
曾经有人用这段经文写在一张卡祝福了你。
You've given this verse to somebody before.
或者你祝福了别人用这段经文。
But I realized something.
可是我发现到。
A lot of people never read verse 7.
很多人读完第五节、第六节没读第七节。
Verse 7 is a good summary.
第七节为这段经文做了很好的总结。
What does it say right there?
他说什么呢？不要自以为有智慧，要敬畏耶和华，远离恶事。
Don't think that you know everything. Don't be wise in your own eyes.
不要自以为你是有智慧的，别不要自以为你什么都懂。
Actually, I think the Mandarin was even better than English, you know.
中文当然是比较好啦。
But 坦白讲，自以为 is really it's a very good phrase.
卖号链呐，就是这个意思。不要自以为。
Okay lah, if you say so lah.
哎，对对对。
No, but isn't that the problem with many of us?
我们很多人都自以为是，对不对？
We all think we know.
我们都以为我们什么都懂。
You come back to the story of my friend I told you just now.
你回到刚才我跟你分享我那个几年前的朋友的故事。
He thought he knew the best decision for his future.
他以为他对着他的未来能做出最好的打算。
He thought he was in a better place to know the situation better.
他以为他懂得这个情况比上帝更懂。
And very often we're just like that.
很多时候我们都是这样子的。
We do in some ways think that we know better than God.
很多时候我们都以为我们懂得比上帝多。
I've actually spoken to someone in church before.
我其实在教会跟教会的一个会友说过话
，and she told me this.
她告诉我
，she actually said that she believes she doesn't agree with everything that God does.
她说上帝的一些的作为呢，她并不是完全认同的。
In fact, she said this. She thinks that she can do better.
她甚至觉得她自己能够做的比上帝更好。
There are people who think like that.
我们的确是有人在当中是这样的想法。
Thinking about all this.
而当我在思考这些事情的时候。
Ultimately, I realize it's about how much you trust God, how much do you see Him as the highest authority.
最终我得问及到你有多信靠神，你有把它摆在第几个位置呢？
This is American. I came across this sermon by an American pastor.
有一位美国的牧师，他讲过一篇道。
He preaches on U.S. radio in the past.
他以前呢，在美国的那个广播电台，他会透过那个电台而讲道。
And he makes this powerful statement.
而他说了这一段非常有力的一段话语。
He says, "This is God's universe, and He does things His way. Now you may think you have a better way of doing things, but you don't have a universe."
他说，这是上帝的世界，他按自己的方式行事。你可能有更好的做事形式方式，但你不拥有世界。
This is not our universe.
这并不是我们的世界。
We are not the ones in charge.
我们不是掌管这世界的人。
God is the one who is in charge.
是上帝在掌管这世界。
And I think it's so important for us to hear this.
我们必须听到这段话。
Because very often we get caught in this trap.
因为我们很多时候都陷入了一个陷阱里面。
Thinking that we know better.
我们一直以为我们懂得比上帝更多。
自以为是。
自以为是。
I want to share with you. I want to close off this point. Just sharing with you one final saying.
我想做一个总结，跟你们分享再多一句名言。
This one is really from C.S. Lewis.
这的确是路易斯作家所讲的。
Let's Paul read it to us.
他说。 你只要骄傲就不能认识上帝。骄傲的人总是看低他人，看低一切。当然，只要你眼睛往下，你就不可能看到在你之上的东西了。
Now, I'm just going to leave that up for a short while.
我们把它摆在屏幕上。
But let's think about this.
我们试想一下。
We read this, right?
你看到这段话。
And we think that it applies to arrogant people.
你就觉得呢，这个呢是应该讲给傲慢的人听的。
Because arrogant people look down other people, right?
因为傲慢的人呢是看低别人的。
But you know, this phrase "look down."
这个看低这个字呢
，is very interesting.
是很有趣的。
Okay, when you're literally looking down, 呢？
当你真的在看低下去的时候呢
？There are only two groups. There are two types of people who look down.
只有两种人是往下看的。
Arrogant people look down.
傲慢的人是会看低别人的。
They look down people, look down situation.
他们看低别人，他们看低那个情况。
What other kind of person looks down?
另外一组人会往下看是谁呢
？Someone who's feeling shameful.
充满着羞愧的人。
They look down also.
他也是低下头。
On one side.
在一方面
，You look down.
你看低别人。
You think other people very beneath you.
你觉得别人不好，很差。
You think they're the worst.
你觉得他们是最差、最烂的。
On this side.
另一方面
，You look down.
你低下头。
Because you're scared to look at other people.
因为你不敢看人。
You don't want people to see you for
who you are. 你也不想别人看见你的真人。
This is all pride.
这些都是骄傲。
In fact, I'll give you a very simple exercise right now.
好，我给你们做一个小小的一个活动。
I want you to physically look down right now.
我要你现在低下头，不要闭上眼睛啊！低下头看下面。
Okay, you look down.
你往下看。
Now you look up.
你现在往前看。
When you look down,
当你往下看的时候
，What is your focus?
你专注在什么呢
？When you're looking down,
当你往下看的时候
，You're actually looking more at yourself. You know,
你在看着你自己，还有你的肚子。
你的肚子？
我自己的肚子。
我的还 OK 了，
你的还好，你还好。
See, if you don't have a mirror,
如果你没有镜子的话
，the best way to look at yourself,
最容易看到自己呢
，is to look down,
就是往下看一看自己啊。
When you look down, you see more of yourself.
当你往下看，你就会看到你几乎全身。
Okay, I can look. If I look at my shoulder here,
如果我看我的肩膀
，I only see my shoulder here.
我只看到我的肩膀。
But when you look down,
可是我往下看
，I see most of my body.
我看见大部分的身体。
What's the point I'm trying to make here?
我想说的是什么呢
？Is that when we're always looking down?
当我们一直往下看的时候
，the main focus of our vision is ourselves.
焦点在于我们自己。
So when you're looking down on other people,
所以当你傲慢，你看低别人的时候
，you're seeing yourself.
你看见自己多么好
，better than you.
我比你好
，I'm up here.
我在高高在上
，you're down there.
你是下面
，you're focusing on your successes.
你在专注于你自己的成就。
When you're over here,
当你在这边羞愧的时候
you're looking down at yourself,
你就一直看着自己
you're analyzing yourself,
一直在分析自己
I'm very stupid
哎呀我很笨啊
I'm not educated
哎呀我不够教育
I'm too young
哎呀我太年轻
old,
我太老
I don't know this
我这不懂我那也不懂
focusing on all your struggles,
你就一直专注在于你生命中的那些失败的事
But like what C.S. Lewis said,
可是正如路易斯所说的
As long as you look down,
只要你往下看
You won't see what is above you.
你就看不见在你之上的。
In fact, to people who are always looking down,
还有那些经常都是往下看的人
，whether out of arrogance or out of shame,
无论是傲慢的人还是羞愧的人
，you're always looking down.
如果你一直是往下看
，let me say this to you.
我要跟你说
，your world becomes very small.
你的世界就会变得很渺小。
Only when you look up,
只有抬头仰望的时候
，and you realize the greatness of everything that is around you,
才看见你四周围之伟大。
Only when you look up, then you realize that there's a God whose mighty hand you can come under.
只要你往上看，才能看见有伟大的神他在眷顾着你。
So today,
所以今天
，we need to look up.
我们必须抬头望
，look up towards God.
我们要仰望上帝
，and lift Him at the highest place.
而将他高举在生命中最重要的位置。
So these are the two things I want to share.
所以我要跟大家分享就是这两大要点。
How can we effectively deal with the pride in our life?
我们应该如何去应付生命中的骄傲呢
？Number one,
第一
，think of yourself less.
少看自己。
But there's a second important point as well.
还有第二很重要的一点
，that we must think more of God.
我们必须抬头多仰望神
，lift Him in the highest place.
将他高举在生命中的第一位。
You know, as I come to a close today,
当我们今天来到这结束了
，I'm reminded of a very simple incident that happened to me and my friends when we were in secondary school.
我回想起当我还在读中学的时候呢，我跟朋友之间发生的事。
I remember secondary school about maybe 16, 17 years ago.
当时是大概16、17年前的事了。
And at that point in time, there was new technology coming up.
当时呢有新科技一直在正上市场。
So one of the latest gadgets at that point in time was the iPod.
所以当时呢就是苹果品牌的那个 iPod 的这个
It was a music player.
是可以听音乐的。
You can put in your pocket.
可以放在口袋里面的。
And the thing about this brand Apple.
这个苹果牌子
Is that they've got very distinctive earpieces.
就是它的耳机呢是很不一样。
Is this white color one?
是白色的，很好看的。
So at that point of time, I mean, we were teenagers.
所以那时候我们还是青少年而已。
Everybody like wanted the latest thing.
每个人都希望买到最新的产品。
Mostly to show off to your other friends.
就是拿来炫耀炫酷。
So there are people getting it.
所以很多人都去买。
I didn't have one.
那时我没有。
But I had this other friend.
我有这同学。
Okay, I mean he was quite a. We always thought he's quite a well-to-do person, right?
我们一直都觉得他的生活的那个情况应该是挺还可以的。
You know, he will always We will see at secondary school then, but he'll take cab everywhere that kind of thing.
他去到哪儿都是坐德士的。
Oh, must be quite a rich family or what?
他来自应该是一个富裕的家庭。
So one day we saw him in school.
所以有一天呢，看到他在学校。
I was listening to his iPod. He was listening to his iPod.
他正在戴着耳机在听着音乐。
And it's obvious because he can wear the white color Apple one. It's very obvious it's his.
所以很容易看得出应该是苹果牌子，因为那个耳机很好看。
Amber.He was walking.
我记得他在走着。
And he was behaving. He was like dancing to the music.
然后他一边走呢，一边在轻跳着，好像在听着音乐这样子。
You know, you listen to music, you like kind of shake your head.
你一边听，就应该会扭一扭，摆一摆的。
Like, kind of dancing,
跟着旋律在摇摆。
And then we all being teenagers.
然后我们是年轻人嘛。
One of my friends want to go and catch out him lah.
我其中一个朋友要去骚扰他。
So this other friend ran up to him.
然后就去跑到他前面。
He said, "Wow, you listen to very short, ah."
哇，你听到很好听啊。
And as he said that,
他这么说的时候
he grabbed the earpiece.
他就拉住那耳机
He just pulled the whole thing.
然后把朋友的耳机给拉下来
And when he pulled it,
拉下来的时候
the whole thing came out.
整个耳机就这个条线就出来了
And they realized that the end was not plugged into anything.
就发现到耳机的另一端其实没有插入任何苹果那个音乐的那个播音机
He didn't have the iPod.
他并没有那个苹果的 iPod.
He just went to buy the earpiece.
他只不过是买了耳机
And he put it in.
然后就塞上了
Every day.
每一天
Like as though he was listening to music.
仿佛他在听音乐一样
Just to show people like he had it.
就是为了要炫耀给朋友看他假设的他好像有一个耳机 有一个音乐的播音机
We think about it now a bit funny.
你是想其实还挺搞笑的
But honestly it's actually very sad.
可是其实是很悲伤的
But many of us do that.
我们很多人都会这样做
People, we try to put on this facade.
我们尝试戴上假面具
Because we're so concerned about ourselves.
因为我们很害怕被人家揭穿
So we want to see. We're so worried about how people look at us, what they think of us.
我们很担心别人会怎么样看待我们
We see. I see in church as well.
我在教会也看见
I give you one example.
我给你打个比喻
Church people 啊
教会的人啊
Now on social media.
现在在社交媒体上
And some of us, we love to post very holy things.
我们很喜欢摆上很圣洁的一些名言。
We every day post this devotion
每天都摆了这个灵修的一些话语。
Post this Bible verse
圣经的经文 这个基督徒所说的一些话。
I'm not saying that's wrong
我并不是说这是错的。
But many of them they do that.
可是很多人会这样做。
But deep inside their walk is not right.
可是其实，在心里面，他们与神并不在同行。
Deep inside they're struggling with a lot of things.
他们心里面其实有很大的挣扎。
But we feel the need to put on this facade.
可是我们觉得我们要戴上这个假面具在社交媒体上。
We want people have the impression that everything is okay.We are doing well.
我们要让别人觉得我们生命是 OK 的，没问题的。
And that is an element of pride.
而这就是有骄傲的一个因素在里面。
Today,
今天
there's some of us here.
我们当中有人
you're looking at your life.
你在反省看自己的生命。
And maybe right now you're in a place where it feels like everything is just not working.
可能你觉得你现在生命中的任何一件事都不顺畅的。
But how come everywhere there's no open door?
为什么我去到哪儿都没有机会就业良机
I mean,
或者是打开的门呢
You want to be obedient to God.
你做的已经尽力了，你要顺服上帝。
So okay, like, I try this different area of my ministry.
所以我就尝试做不一样的事工。
Let's go and do this 幸福小组 do everything.
我们去做幸福小组，我们什么都做。
Not working out.
可是就是不成功。
Or maybe it's in the area of your work or your family. family，
甚至是在工作上，在家庭里面。
You keep trying different things, but there's no success.
你尝试不一样的东西，可是就是没有什么成就。
And you know what？
你知道吗
？We can go on for the rest of our lives blaming the world, blaming this, blaming that.
我们可以花上一辈子的时间来责备、来怪这社会啊，怪这个怪那个。
But maybe we've missed the point.
可是可能我们错过了要点。
Maybe God is trying to get us to wake up.
可能上帝要让我们苏醒起来。
Because maybe there's pride in our lives.
因为可能我们生命有骄傲。
And God Himself opposes the proud.
而上帝会阻挡骄傲的人。
Today we must come and deal with this pride.
今天我们必须回到主的面前来应付面对这个问题。
We must think of ourselves less and we must think more of God.
我们必须少看自己，多仰望神。
You know who was the best example who did that?
你知道做了这件事最好的榜样是谁吗？
Jesus Christ Himself.
耶稣基督本人。
He learned to humble himself.
他学习谦卑自己。
Get rid of any kind of consciousness of yourself.
他不再看自己。
And focus on God.
而专注在于神。
Let's look at Philippians chapter 2 verses 5 to 8.
我们看看腓立比书第二章第五节到第八节。你们当以基督耶稣的心为心，他本有神的形象，不以自己与神同等为强夺的，反倒虚己，取了奴仆的形象，成为人的样式，既有人的样式。的样子就自己卑微，存心顺服，以至于死，并且死在十字架上。
Listen to this 啊，
你再读一读啊。
He was in very nature God.
他本有神的这个形象的。
But did not count that to be used as his advantage.
他当不，可是他不以自己与神同等的那个优势成为他自己的一个。
He humbled himself, stepped down, and become a man.
他愿意谦卑自己，成为人的样式。
And not just that, he humbled himself to die on the cross.
不单如此，他卑微自己，存心顺服，以至于死。
This is very important to talk about.
这是非常重要的。
Today, the cross is a religious symbol.
今天我们戴上的这个十字架呢，是一个宗教性的象征。
But some of us we may not know, but back in that time, the cross was a tool for execution.
可是你们不知道的，就是在那个时候，十字架的确是判死刑、刑罚的一个工具。
I'm sure many of us are wearing a cross somewhere now.
可能我们当中有人也在项链戴上十字架了。
You know, if you go back in time,
如果你回去到以前历史的时候
，People see you wearing a cross.
有人看到你戴着十字架
，They would think you're mad.
他们觉得你是疯的。
It'll be like today,
就好像今天
，You wear a necklace.
你戴项链
，With an electric chair hanging there.
然后里面有电椅。
Is a tool to kill people, one.
是拿来判死刑、审罚的一个工具。
Not just that, the cross was a very shameful thing.
不单如此，十字架是一个充满羞愧的一个东西。
Only the worst of criminals were put there.
只有最劣等的这个囚犯才会被。死在十字架上。
And the cross was designed to prolong your suffering before you die.
而这个十字架的这个用途呢，就是让你慢慢置于死地。
So let's come back to the life of Jesus.
所以我们就回到耶稣的一生。
Do you think it's easy for Jesus to go on that cross to die for us?
你们觉得耶稣到十字架上为我们而死是很容易的一件事吗？
No, he struggled.
他有很大的挣扎。
The night before he went to God and prayed.
在之前的一晚，他还来到神的面前来祷告。
He said, God, if it's possible.
他说，主啊，如果可以的话。
Take this away from me.
求你拿走这杯。
But he ended up with one important line.
他加了一句，但是，很重要的一句话。
But not my will, but yours be done.
可是并不是我的旨意，而是要成就主你的旨意。
That one line.
他说的那一句话。
Basically shows how he's thinking less of himself and more of God.
让我们看见了他如何少看自己，而他一直是仰赖着、依靠着耶和华。
It's not about what he wants; it's about what God is calling him to do.
并不是他想做的，而是上帝要透过他想做的。
And it's so interesting. You look at Philippians chapter 2 there.
你们回到看看刚才腓立比书第二章的。
It talks about how Jesus humbled himself.
他说耶稣自己卑微起来。
He humbled himself and went through such a shameful thing.
他谦卑自己，然后他经历了那么充满着羞愧的十字架的路。
But immediately the next verse says this.
可是他下一句说了什么呢？第九节。所以神将他升为至高，又赐给他那超乎万民之上的名。
Think about that,
试想一下。
Jesus was brought down to the lowest of the lowest place.
耶稣被降生为人，去到了最卑微、最卑贱的一个地位。
He went through the most shameful thing.
他经历了最这个羞愧的这十字架的过程。
But yet ultimately,
最终
despite that,
就算他经历了这些
He was exalted above everything.
神将他升为最高。
Because at the end of the day, it is God who exalts us.
因为最终是神会使我们被升为最高。
That's an interesting thing, you know.
这非常重要。
God is always above us, of course.
上帝当然是在我们之上的了。
And pride tries to bring ourselves up.
而因为有骄傲，我们想把自己摆到跟神同等位置。
But it's very funny.
可是这个是很奇妙的。
If you study scripture,
当你钻研经文
，God's word says this, you know.
上帝的话语说
，The more you lower yourself,
你越是谦卑自己，降低自己的身份
，The more He will come and meet you and lift you up.
上帝更会去到你卑微的位置，把你升起来。
If you want to be lifted up,
如果你要被上帝升为至高的话
，The way is to be humble before God.
就是要谦卑自己在神的面前。
Let's come back.To where we started.
我们要回到最初的原点。
First Peter chapter 5 verse 6.
彼得前书第五章第六节告诉我们，所以你们要自卑，伏在神大能的手下，到了时候他必叫你们升高。
When you humble yourself before God, He is the one who lifts you up.
当你自卑伏在神的手下的时候，他才可以把你升高。
Now today, I'm sure that many of us here who need to hear this word.
今天我相信有很多人需要听到这段话语。
We are trying to strive to put ourselves somewhere.
我们很努力的要把自己放在一个很好的位置。
And as a result, pride creeps into our hearts.
而结果呢，我们就被骄傲给充满了。
Some of us we become fixated on our successes.
有些人呢，就开始很看重自己的成就。
Some of us we become fixated on our failures.
我们就很看重自己的所失败之处。
And we get caught in this loop.
然后我们就一直在这个恶性循环里面无法自拔。
But today God wants to set us free from all this.
可是今天上帝要释放我们，让我们得自由。
Because that's why He came.
因为他就是为了这件事而来的。
You see, when man fell into sin,
当人犯罪的时候
sin is basically rebelling from God, turning away from God.
罪就是离开神，然后离他越来越远。
And all of us have turned away from God.
而我们呢，都是转开了，然后离开了神。
And the Bible says that because of this sin, we should all be destroyed.
而圣经教导我们，因为我们有罪，我们都应该以至于灭亡的。
But God didn't give up on us.
可是上帝并没有放弃我们。
He refused to do that.
他不要放弃我们。
So instead of causing us to be destroyed,
与其让我们导致最终会得着灭亡。
He sent His Son Jesus to die as a sacrifice.
他就差派了他的儿子耶稣基督为我们的罪而死。
Why? Because you and I are so precious to Him.
为什么呢？那是因为对他来说，我们是他的无价之宝。
That's why John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son for us."
所以圣经教导我们在约翰三章第十六节告诉我们，因为神爱世人，甚至将独生子拆到地上来为我们的罪而死。
He would rather sacrifice His only Son.For us, then lose us and still have His Son.
他愿意牺牲他的独生子，就是为了我们，也不要失去我们。
And I like what John 3:17 then says.
而我非常喜欢第十七节后来所说的。
For God did not send Jesus to condemn the world, but so that through Him we may be saved.
因为上帝差耶稣来，不是要定世人的罪，而是透过耶稣，我们都能得救。
I know in our world today there are many people who carry a spirit of condemnation.
我知道现在很多人在世上，你都带着一个很被诋毁的一个灵。
And some of us we feel condemned because of the things that people have said to us.
因为很多人是跟你说的话，说你没有用，说你不够好。
You know, we tend to remember all these things.
我们都会记住这些负面的话语。
I mean, even myself.
就连我自己。
I'm very sensitive to these kind of words.
对这种话语我也特别敏感的，其实。
I still can remember the moments that my dad called me stupid when I was growing up.
我还记得我。我小长大的时候，我爸爸说你笨笨的，他就记得这句话。
When my teachers would scold me and say the same thing also.
我记得当我老师说我很笨的时候，我也是牢记
在心。Of course, God has set me free from.
当然，上帝已经释放了我。
But I can still remember it.
可是我还记得。
And we're all the same.
而我们都一样。
We remember the times that we were told that I'm a failure.
当有人说你是失败者的时候，你也会记得那一刻。
That you're a mistake.
说生你出来是意外。
That you are not loved.
说你是不被爱的。
And you'll never be good enough.
你永远都不够好。
We remember.All those things.
我们都会记得这些负面的话。
But Jesus came so that we will not be condemned.
可是耶稣来，好让我们不再被这些话语所伤害。
So that we will be set free.
好让我们得着释放。
And because of what Jesus did on the cross.
而因着耶稣为我们在十字架上所做的。
We now can our relationship with God is restored.
我们现在就恢复了之前跟上帝的关系。
We can come before Him in humility.
我们可以来到他的施恩宝座前，我们谦卑。
And He will lift us up.
而他会把我们高举。
Today, I know that some of us who don't know who Jesus is.
我知道今天我们在座有人不认识耶稣。
But for some reason, you're here in service this weekend.
可是你有朋友邀请你来了，你就来了。
Today, God is calling out to you.
今天上帝在呼唤着你。
This message is for all of us.
这段话语是给每一个人的，今天的信息。
Maybe you are the one who knows that you've been struggling in this area.
可能你知道你在这一方面有很大的挣扎。
Maybe you're fixated on all your successes.
可能你一直在专注于你自己的成就。
Or maybe you're stuck in this cycle of being fixated on all your struggles.
又或者你的重心在于你所失败的事。
Or maybe you feel like you constantly need to strive and look out for yourself.
又或者你一直要很努力的去把东西做好来照顾好自己。
Because nobody will ever look out for you.
因为没有人会看顾你的。
But that's not true.
可是这不是真的。
God loves you.
上帝爱你。
God cherishes you.
他很珍惜你。
And he calls you his son, he calls you his daughter.
他呼召你，他称你为儿女。
I want to close with this one last truth.
我要分享最后一段真理。
Nobody is an accident.
但我们没有一个人是意外。
Nobody is a mistake.
没有人是错误的。
Because God's word says that you are his masterpiece.
因为上帝在圣经的话语告诉我们，我们都是他的佳作，他的杰作。
You know, I've talked about this verse with people before.
我经常会跟人家分享这段话。
Say, Pastor, how can you say that we are all God's masterpiece?
那个人就会问我，牧师，你怎么会说我们都是上帝的杰作呢？
It's like saying we're all special.
就好像说我们每一个人都是很特别的。
If everyone is special, then nobody is special.
如果每一个人都特别的话，还有谁才真正的特别呢？
Ask a parent.
你就是问一名家长吧。
Your three children.
家长们，你有三个孩子。
Are they all special to you?
他们对你来说都是特别的吗？
Of course, they're all special to you.
当然，他们都很独特。
You talk about a masterpiece.
你说到一名画，一名杰作。
One day I went to search online for all these famous artists.
有一天，我都去到网上去找很多这些画家。
So I typed the artist name.
我就写了画家的名字。
Then I put masterpiece.
然后我就写画家杰作。
And then the results came out, right?
然后那个结果出来了。
All of them don't have one masterpiece.
他们不是每个画家都不只有一个杰作。
Many masterpieces.
他们有很多的杰作。
Because they're all unique, they're all special, they're all of such great value and worth.
因为对画家来说，每一幅画都是有它的价值，都很重要。
See, what makes you a masterpiece is not how many different drawings there are out there, you know?
让你觉得是佳作的、杰作的，并不是因为你画了多少幅画。
What makes you a masterpiece?
你是什么让你成为上帝的杰作呢？
Is how much care and concern the artist put in creating.
是在于画家在创造你的时候，他花了多少心思。
And the Bible says in Psalm 139 that He knit us together in the wombs of our mothers.
而圣经在诗篇139呢，上帝就是在母腹里面已经把我们给细心的创造出来。
His word says that we were wonderfully and marvelously created.
他的话语告诉我们，他创造我们是美好又奇妙的。
So today, if you're here and you don't know Jesus,
所以如果今天你来了而你不认识耶稣基督，
I want to close off this sermon giving you a chance to respond.
在结束之前，我要给你们一个机会回应。
I'm going to lead us in the word of prayer in a short while.
我会带领大家做一个祷告。
This prayer is designed for those of you who have never acknowledged Jesus as your Lord.
这个祷告呢，是设计起来是给从未接受耶稣基督成为你个人救主的人的。
I'm going to say this prayer out loud.
我会大声的把这个祷告给说出来。
And today, if you know you need to respond,
今天如果你有感动，你知道你要回应的话，
I want you to pray out loud along with us.
我要你一同跟着我一句一句的祷告。
We'll say it as we say it line by line. Say everything we say.
我们说的每一句话，你就一句一句的跟我们说出来。
And I want all the Christians here to pray together.
而希望所有的基督徒也会跟着我们一起做这祷告。
So that nobody prays alone.
好，让每个人不会觉得他是独自在祷告的。
So I invite all of us to close our eyes and bow our heads.
所以现在呢，我邀请大家，你低下头，你闭上眼睛。
This is a very special moment.
这是一个很重要的时刻。
But there are many people here.
我们有很多人。
And over there in Gateway Theatre.
也在嘉伟剧院。
God is speaking to you this afternoon.
上帝现在正在感动着你，跟你说话。
Don't let this moment pass you by.
不要错失这个良机。
Don't today come and respond to Him.
今天你来做一个回应吧。
So if all our heads bow, all our eyes closed.
所有的头低下来，眼睛都闭上。
Let's come and pray together right now.
我们一起来做祷告。亲爱的天父，
亲爱的天父，
我感谢你对我的大爱。
我感谢你对我的大爱。
我知道我是你所创作的佳作。
我知道我是你所创作的佳作。
今天我对你敞开我的心。
今天我对你敞开我的心。
主耶稣，
主耶稣，
感谢你为我死在十字架上。
感谢你为我死在十字架上。
今天我要跟随你。
今天我要跟随你。
求你洁净我的罪。
求你洁净我的罪。
让我恢复可以来到你面前，
让我恢复可以来到你的面前。
你的的确确是我的救主，
你的的确确是我的救主。
谢谢你耶稣，
谢谢你耶稣。
With all heads bowed and eyes closed,
我们继续的低下头，闭上眼睛。
I believe that some of us here today, you prayed this prayer for the first time.
我相信在座有人是第一次做这样的祷告。
And if that's you,
如果这是你的话
what I'm going to do right now is this.
我现在要做的是
I'm going to count to three.
我即将会数到三。
And the moment you hear me say three,
你听我数到三
if you pray along with me,
如果你陪同我一起做祷告
I want you to lift your hand straight up where you are.
我要你举起你的手举得高高的。
I want you to lift it up so I can see who you are and where you are.
你的手举得高高的，好让我能看见你，你在哪里。
Because I want to speak a word of blessing over you.
因为我要做祝福的祷告在你身上。
But maybe you weren't praying out loud.
可能你没有大声的祷告出来。
Maybe you were quietly praying.
可能你是默默的在祷告。
Or maybe you didn't do anything at all.
可能你没有做任何事情。
But right now you know you need to respond.
可是你现在有感动，你知道你要回应。
Then at the count of three, you lift your hand straight up.
那我数到三，你就举起你的手吧。
The others here, you've been far away from the Lord.
这在座有其他的人，你离神很远。
But for some reason, today you came back to church.
可是今天你来了。
This message is for you as well.
这段话语是给你的。
Today, why don't you turn back to the Lord?
今天你回转向上帝吧。
And if that's you, at the count of three, you lift your hand straight up.
如果这是你的话，你也举起你的手吧。
Because I want to pray for all of you.
因为我要为你做祝福祷告。
So I'm going to count right now.
所以我要数到三。
All over here and over there at Gateway.
在这里也在教会剧院。
At the count of three, you lift your hand straight up.
数到三，你举起你的手。
One,
一
two,
二
and three.
三，
just lift your hand straight up.
举起你的手。
Yes, I see your hands over here.
我看见你的手。
Yes, I see your hands over here in touch center.
我看到你在出外。我看到在教会剧院也有人举手。
Yes, just keep it lifted high. Is there anyone?
举得高高的，不要害怕。
Don't let this moment pass you.
不要错过这个良机。
I want to pray for you right now.
我要为你祷告。
Lord, I thank you for all these hands that are lifted up.
主，我感谢你那么多手举起来。
Because every hand represents a life.
因为所举起来的手都是生命。
And to all our friends here.
而对我们的朋友说
，I bless you.
我祝福你。
That this is the greatest day of your life.
这是你生命中最美好的一天。
Because your life will never be the same again.
你的生命再也不一样。
Because God God is with you.
因为上帝与你同在。
He lives inside of you.
他活在你里面。
You are not alone.
你并不是独自一人的。
And He will be with you every step of the way.
他会在每一步都带领着你与你同在。
So I bless you with this.
所以我祝福你。
I commit you into His hands.
我将你交在主的手中。
You can put your hands down.
你手可以放下来了。
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Can we praise the Lord? Hallelujah.
我们赞美主好不好？
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And let's stand over here and over there at Gateway.
好不好？我们站起来，在这里也在嘉伟剧院。
I saw quite a number of hands lifted up.
我看到很多只手都举起来了。
And so here's what we're going to do.
所以我们现在要做的是什么呢？
I'm going to count to three again shortly.
我要再一次数到三声。
This time when I say three.
这次我数到三。
All those of you lift up your hands.
举起手的。
I want to invite you to grab your things and make your way to the front.
我邀请你拿着你的包包来到前面来。
It's all right. You're not going to come alone.
你不是独自一人走到前面。
Your friends will come down with you as well.
带你来的朋友也会带你来。
We want to bring you forward so that the whole family here can pray over you.
来到前面，我们大家为你欢呼。
And some of you maybe you didn't lift up your hands.
可能你没有举起手。
But you know you need to respond.
可是你知道你要做回应。
Tell your friends they'll be happy to bring you forward.
告诉你的朋友，他会带你到前面来。
Others you pray a similar prayer at a private setting.
其他人在一个小组的形式做过这样的祷告。
But you never responded at a service.
可是你从未在教会回应过。
Tell your friends and they'll bring you down as well.
告诉你的朋友吧，叫他带你到前面来。
And FCBC members.
我们教会的会友。
If you brought a guest.
如果你带了新朋友。
Ask if they'd like to respond.
你会问他要不要回应。
If they would just come on down with it.
如果他愿意的话，带他到前面。
So I'm going to count to three right now.
所以现在数到三了。
You grab your stuff, you make your way down.
你拿着你的包包来到前面。
And church, let's welcome them.
教会，我们欢迎他们，好不好？
One, two, and three. Just come down, grab your stuff. We want to pray for you.
要为你祷告。
We want to celebrate together with you.
要一同欢庆。
Let's come here and over there at Gateway Theater as well.
也在教会剧院来到前面吧。
Just come.
就来到前面。
We want to congratulate you. We're going to pray with you.
要为你一起祷告。
We're so happy for you.
我们替你高兴。
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, I know there were other hands lifted up just now as well.
我知道还有其他的手刚才举起来的。
But if for whatever reason you're not coming forward, it's all right.
可是如果你真的不愿意来到前面，无所谓的。
Your friends will spend some time with you later on.
你的朋友会继续跟你对话、聊天、祷告。
But for all those of you in the front here.
可是来到前面来的朋友。
And over there at Gateway as well.
还有在嘉伟剧院。
You know, as you choose to acknowledge Jesus as your Lord today.
当你愿意认耶稣为你生命的主的时候。
It doesn't mean that life will be perfect. Nothing will ever.
并不是说从此以后生命就完美啦。
I think all of us have lived life enough to know that there are always ups and there are always downs.
我们基督徒们都知道，我们生命中会有起起落落。
And the promise that God has for us is this.
上帝赐给我们的应许是
that whether it's in the high moments or the low moments.
无论你经历人生的 高峰低谷。
That you can be strong and courageous.
你可以选择刚强壮胆。
Because God goes with you.
因为上帝在你前面与你同行。
He will never leave you. He will never abandon you.
他绝对不会抛弃你，也不会撇下你。
And that's the truth I want to bless all of you.
而这是我要跟你分享圣经里面的真理。
And right now, the whole family wants to pray over you.
而现在我们这个大家庭要为你们祷告。
So just do me a favor, close your eyes and bow your heads again.
所以呢，在前面的朋友，你就低下头，闭上眼睛，好不好
？Hey, church, stretch out hands towards them.
而教会我们伸手按举手为他们祷告。
Lord, we commit all our friends into your hands.
主啊，我们将这些朋友交在你手中。
We thank you for what you're doing in their lives.
感谢你在他们生命中赐给他们感动。
Come and fill their lives.
来充满他们生命。
Bless them in all that they do.
他们所做的一切都祝福着他们。
In their studies and their work.
学业工作。
In their relationships.
关系里面。
Bless their families, Lord.
祝福他们的家人。
And Lord, bless their health.
祝福他们的健康。
And we ask right now.
我们求主啊。
That you'll fill them with your love.
你会用你的爱来充满他们。
So much.
满溢出来
，so that it flows out to every single person.
好，让他会满溢，然后流到身边的人都感受到主的爱。
So our friends here, we thank God for you.
所以朋友们，我们因着你们而感谢神。
We bless you.
祝福你们。
In Jesus' name, we pray.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
赞美主。Hallelujah.
And just follow one of our staff, one of our leaders here.
跟着我们同工到那边去。
And church, come on, let's thank the Lord for them once again.
教会，我们感谢主，好不好？我们其余的，我们举起手好不好
？I want to bless you from Proverbs 3. This
我要用箴言第三章的话语来祝福大家。
Church, I bless you with this.
教会，我祝福大家。
That you always trust in the Lord with all your heart.
你会时常专心仰赖耶和华。
You will not depend on your own understanding.
你不会依靠自己的聪明。
In everything you do, you will submit to Him.
在你所做的事上都要认定他。
And He will make your path straight.
而上帝必指引你的路。
May you never try to be wise in your own ways.
愿你千千万万不要自以为有智慧。
But you always fear the Lord.
而你时常都要敬畏耶和华。
And you will shun evil.
而远离恶事。
May you be blessed as you live your life this way.
愿你这样活出你的生命的时候，你必蒙福。
Lord, we lay down our pride.
主啊，我们摆下我们的骄傲。
We lay down all our successes.
我们摆下我们所有的成就。
We lay down all our struggles as well.
我们摆下我们所有的挣扎。
And we declare that you are above it all.
而我们宣告，主啊，你在这些事之上。
God, you are the Lord of our lives.
主啊，你是我们生命的主。
We commit ourselves afresh into your hands.
我们重新将自己交托在你手中。
And church, I bless you.
而教会，我祝福大家。
In this week ahead,
在来临这一周
，God's grace will be upon you.
上帝的恩典必临到你。
His presence will be with you.
他的同在与你同在。
And you will continue to encounter His goodness.
你会继续的经历他的美善。
I bless you with this.
我祝福你们。
In Jesus' mighty name.
奉耶稣大能的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. We'll see you next week.
上帝祝福大家，我们下星期见。
Remember, it's our baptism weekend. It's very exciting.
记得是我们的洗礼周末，有90个人要洗礼啊。
So bring a friend, and it's going to be a great time.
所以带朋友来，这是一个奇妙的时间。上帝祝福你们。